James Bartleman was born on December 24, 1939. He is the former Lieutenant Governor of Ontario from 2002 to 2007, a distinguished diplomat that has served in countries such as Israel, South Africa, and Australia. Believes we all have a moral compass that we must follow. How do we distinguish right from wrong in society? What are the methods that we use to guide ourselves? Kant's idea of universal morality should be a guiding principle for society to follow. This documentary will look at how Kant's philosophy influenced James Bartleman's moral compass and the duty he takes upon himself as a former public servant.
You know, and honesty is what you require in diplomacy. But there are sometimes you're asked to do things which go against your moral compass. And that's when that truism comes into play, that you're asked to lie.
So, why do I have this compass up here? Because a second attribute of leadership that I want to pass on to you is integrity. It's moral compass. In being a leader, you have to have a moral compass. There has to be integrity in everyday life, in decisions, in work, in relationships. Your yes has got to be a yes. Your no has got to be a no. Your word has to be your bond. People have to be able to trust you. They have a right to be able to trust you. And if you breach that trust, you're done. You're done as a leader.
Kant's theory of human rights derives from his belief in a person's dignity and worth as inherent traits in personhood. He argues people should be treated with respect, a vital notion in human rights. Moreover, his theory of why individuals are to be treated respectfully is formed in terms of common differentiations between means and ends. This suggests a person's life should not be used to achieve an action. He argues people are rational and autonomous beings. They must be used as ends in themselves. Thus, being a person allows humans to be subject of rational moral reason, thus the ability to apply the categorical imperative and establish the rule for respecting others. Accordingly, every person is entitled to rights, and only through mutually sustaining acts of recognition can those rights be upheld.
To use information derived from torture in extraordinary circumstances, as long as we didn't do the torturing ourselves. And the extraordinary circumstances were very vaguely defined. Risk of life of a Canadian, risk to Canadian economic interests. Torture is of a different dimension. Torture, you know, is the people screaming and dying. We join the ranks of the world's torturers when we join the ranks. It's even worse in a way if you ask other people to do it for you. Arad, where the RCMP provided the information to the United States to have them send him to Syria to be tortured. The establishment really doesn't want the truth. And I was really disgusted. And so, our actions from that point, I really realized that the easiest thing to do normally is to whip up public fervor in favor of strict measures which diminish civil liberties to deal with a perceived threat.
Could you give future Canadians a few simple words of advice on success?
Well, I think the most important thing for people as a whole is to develop resilience at an early stage so that you're able to deal with the tough things that you face in life. And to develop resilience, you need to be literate, you need to have education, you need to have family that supports you, and you need to go to work.
shall